Hi students, welcome back to Parth Online Maths Tutorial. Today we are going to start exercise 2.3 and this exercise is also based on multiplication of fractions. So we already have seen fractions की multiplication कैसे करते हैं and we'll keep on revising it while doing these questions. So in question number 1 what we have, find 1 by 4 of, it has 3 parts A, B and C. Now question number 1 has 2 parts but we are going to do only 1 part because the second one you can try by yourself. So in first part we have to find 1 by 4th of, in first part 1 by 4 of 1 by 4. And in second part we have to find 1 by 4th of 3 by 5. And in third part we have to find 1 4th of 4 by 3. So let's start A part first, 1 by 4 of 1 by 4. This 1 by 4 as it is, in place of we can write multiply here. And this 1 by 4 as it is. And when we multiply this, we have already discussed when we multiply two fractions, we multiply their corresponding numerators and corresponding denominators. So multiplying 1 by 1 we get 1 and multiplying 4 into 4 we get 16. So this is very simple. Let's now see B part. In B part we have to find 1 fourth of 3 by 5. So we write 1 fourth in place of 4, we'll write multiply and 3 by 5 as it is. Now in these two fractions we cannot cancel out anything. So 1 into 3 will become 3 and 4 into 5 will become 20. So this is the answer in this case. Let's move on to C part now. Here we have to find 1 fourth of 4 by 3. Now see, in these fractions we can cancel out these two 4s. So what we get is 1 into 1 and 1 into 3 and 1 into 3 is 3. So the final fraction here becomes 1 by 3. So this is very easy question. We have done similar question in previous exercise also. So you can try the second part by yourself. Let's now move forward to question number 2. Here we have to first multiply the fraction and then change them to lowest form if possible. So question 2 has 7 parts but we are going to do only first and seventh part because remaining all the parts are same. You can do all the parts having done these two parts. Now in the first part we have a proper fraction and a mixed fraction. To multiply these two fractions, we first have to change this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So this 2 by 3 remains as it is. And when we change this mixed fraction into improper fraction, how can we change? 3 into 2 is 6 and 6 plus 2 is 8. So we get 8 by 3 here. Now we cannot cancel 2 and 3. We cannot cancel 8 and 3 also. So we have to simply multiply the numerators and denominators here. So when we multiply it, it will become 16 by, because 2 into 8 is 16 and 3 into 3 is 9. So we have done the first step, we have multiplied the fractions. Now we have to change it into lowest form. Now can we change into lowest form any further? No, because they don't have a common multiple. So what we can do here is, we can change this improper fraction into mixed fraction. So when we change this into mixed fraction, we'll get 9 ones are 9. And when 9 is subtracted from 16, we get, we have seen in previous lecture also how can we divide up improper fraction into mixed fraction. So it is very easy, you can do it. Now let's do the seventh part. In seventh part we have one proper fraction and one improper fraction. Now to multiply this, it is very simple because nothing can be cancelled out. 4 and 5 are not divisible, 12 and 7 are not divisible, nor this 12 and 5 is divisible. So there is nothing divisible, so we can multiply the numerators and denominators straight away. 4 into 12 is 48 and 7 into 5 is 35. So this way we have multiplied the fractions, but can we change it into lowest form? No, because they don't have any common multiple. So what we can do here is we can change it into mixed fraction. To change it into mixed fraction, we'll divide 48 by 35. So 35 ones are 35 and when we subtract 35 from 48, we'll get 13. So we have 13 as remainder, 35 as divisor and 1 as quotient here. Now how we write improper fraction into mixed fraction? We first of all write divisor, then quotient here and then remainder. So jab hum 48 by 35 ko change karenge mixed fraction mein, we'll write 35 because 35 is the divisor and then quotient here 1 and then remainder. So this way we can easily change improper fraction into mixed fraction. We have seen this in previous lectures also. It is very easy, we all can do it. Now let's see the third question of exercise 2.3. It also has 7 parts, but we'll do only first and last part because all the parts are same, only the values are changing here. So what we have to do in this case, we have to do 3 things here. We have to first multiply and reduce them to lowest form if possible. Then after multiplying, we have to tell whether the fraction is proper or improper. And in third part, we have to change the improper fraction into mixed fraction. If the fraction comes out to be improper fraction, we have to change it into improper fraction. So let's start first part. In first part, we have a proper fraction and a mixed fraction. To multiply these two, we have to change it into improper fraction first. So we'll write 2 by 5 as it is, and we'll change this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So 4 as it is, and when we multiply 4 and 5, we get 20. 20 plus 1 is 21. So on changing this mixed fraction into improper fraction, we get 21 by 4. Now is there anything which can be cancelled out here? Yes, here this 2 and 4 can be cancelled out. 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. So on multiplying, we'll get 1 into 21 is 21 and 5 into 2 is 10. We have done the first part. We have multiplied the fraction. Can we reduce it into lowest form? No, because 10 and 21 are not divisible. So what kind of fraction is it? It is an improper fraction. This is what we have to tell in the second part, because numerator is greater than the denominator. So this fraction is an improper fraction. Now in third part, we have to change the improper fraction into mixed fraction. How can we change it? We have just seen it. We'll divide 21 by 10. So 10 twos are 20. And when 20 is subtracted from 21, we get 1 as remainder. So this way we can write very easily this improper fraction into mixed fraction. Let's now move on to last part. Here also we have a mixed fraction and a proper fraction. To multiply these two, we have to change this mixed fraction into improper fraction first. So how can we change it? This 7 remains as it is. 7 into 3 is 21. 21 plus 4 will be 25 into this 3 by 5 as it is. Now can we cancel out anything here? Yes, this 25 and 5 can be cancelled out here. So when we cancel this out, 5 1s are 5 and 5 5s are 25. So on multiplying, it will become 5 into 3, 15, and 7 into 1 is 7. So we have done the first step, we have multiplied. Can we reduce it any further? No, because 15 and 7 are not divisible. So second part, is it a proper or improper fraction? It is improper fraction because numerator is greater than denominator. Now in C part, we have to change the improper fraction into mixed fraction. So how can we change it? We write the divisor as it is. Now 7 2s are 14. And when we subtract 14 out of 15, we'll get 1 as remainder. So this way we can easily change this improper fraction into mixed fraction. So this is very easy. We can all do this. And the same way we can try all the parts of this question. Let's now move to question number 4. In question number 4, we have to tell which is greater. 2 7th of 3 by 4 or 3 5th of 5 by 8. So compare karne se pehle hume in dono ko multiply karna chahiye. Let's do this question in steps. In first step, we'll multiply these two fractions. So we have 2 by 7. And in place of 4, we can write multiply 3 by 4. Now when we multiply these two, can we cancel out anything here? These 2 and 4 are divisible. So 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. So on multiplying, 1 into 3 will become 3 and 7 into 2 will become 14. So we get 3 by 14 in first case. In step 2, let's multiply these two fractions. So we have 3 by 5 here. In place of 4, we can write multiply and 5 by 8 here. Now we can simply cancel these 5 out. So what we get here is 3 into 1 is 3 and 1 into 8 is 8. Now to compare which fraction is greater, we can either use LCM method or we can use cross multiplication method. So let's compare it using cross multiplication. So we have 3 by 14 and 3 by 8. Now what we do in cross multiplication, we always shift the denominators. We never shift the numerator. The numerator of left hand side remains on left hand side. The numerator of right hand side remains on right hand side. So let's put this comma as it is. This 3 will remain on its place because it is numerator. 8 will be shifted to left hand side. Now this 3 will remain on right hand side because this is numerator, and this 14 will be shifted to right hand side. Now 3 into 8 is 24 and 3 into 14 is 42. Therefore, we can clearly see that 42 is greater than 24, or we can say 24 is less than 42. Thus, we can say 3 by 14 is less than 3 by 8. Or we can say 2/7 of 3 by 4 is less than 3/5 of 5 by 8. So, in the same way, we can try the second part also. That's all for this lecture. Thank you.